Hi, today we continue our journey in solving differential equations in MATLAB. In the previous tutorial, I discussed the analytical solutions of ODEs using dsolve command. Now it's time to numerically solve initial value problems using ODE 45. ODE 45 can solve first order differential equations in their standard form. So the first step to solve ODEs using this command is writing your equation in this form. Now let's start with an example.
Y prime equals to y squared, and the initial value is minus 3. It's a simple ODE, and we can compare the numerical solution with the exact solution. The equation is already in the standard form. Now we should define this function, f. For this simple case, I define it as an anonymous function, but for more complex ones, you should define it in a separate m file. To know more about the topic, you can check my tutorial about defining functions. F equals to @t, y to the power of 2. Two important notes here. Always vectorize your equation. And when you are defining this function, always make both t and y the independent variables, even if t is unused. Now I type help ODE45 to see the general form of using it. T out and y out are the resulting t and y solutions. ODE fun is the function handle we just defined. T span is the interval of integration. I want to solve from 0 to 5. And this is the initial value, minus 3. Remember that this initial value is always associated with the beginning of your time span. Then I can plot y versus t. This is my answer. Let's take a look at t. It goes from 0 to 5, as I defined here. But the step size is not a constant value. MATLAB's ODE45 algorithm modifies this step size according to the answer. It makes ODE45 a very powerful and convenient ODE solver. Let me add the plot of the analytical solution to check my answer. I define y as a symbolic function of t. Then I define the symbolic equation and solve it using dsolve. I've discussed these steps in my previous tutorial. You can see that numerical and analytical solutions match perfectly. Now let's solve a system of first-order differential equations. This is the system of equations. Here the independent variable is x, not t. So my equations should be in this standard form. Now I extract out d over dx. Obviously here y is the vector of unknown variables, u and v. And now my equation is in the standard form. ODE45 takes the function handle, so I have to add an @ before f. Then I'll have time span and initial values. To define my function f, I have to define this vector. So I name the output argument dy dt, which is equal to this vector. Obviously, I cannot run this code since MATLAB doesn't know what u and v are. The function receives x and y as input arguments. So I can define u and v accordingly. U is the first element of y, and v is the second element of y. Now I run the code. Let me take a look at x and y. X goes from 0 to 5 as expected. And y is a matrix with two columns, u and v. I can plot u and v versus x, also give them a legend. The next part is solving a second order differential equation. As I have mentioned multiple times, this is the general form of equation that ODE 45 solves. But how can I write a second order differential equation in this form? The trick is to decompose this second order equation into two first order equations. My two unknown variables are going to be theta and theta prime. To avoid confusion, I renamed them y1 and y2. Now I want to write two equations in this form. y1 prime is equal to y2, and y2 prime is equal to negative sine of y1. It is obvious that both of these equations are in the standard form. Now we can easily solve this system of first order differential equations. First, I define my function f. Now I solve the ODE for 7 seconds and apply the initial conditions too. I also plot theta and theta prime. This procedure may look complicated at first, but after a little practice you can master it. Also, there are other methods to solve differential equations which are easier, such as using symbolic toolbox. So make sure you follow my next tutorials for other methods of solving differential equations. Now let's deal with a more complex example. Consider Kepler's equation. The equations are like this. Here, x and y are functions of t and they represent the coordinates of the moving body. You can also see the initial conditions. Also, consider e to be 0.9. Two second order equations are going to be four first order equations. What should be the four unknown variables then? X, x prime, y, y prime. Now I write four equations. I define the function f and dy dt is equal to this. Now that I have defined my function, I can run ODE45 for 10 seconds, and I also add initial conditions. You can see the results here. I also plot x and y coordinates of the moving body. You see it revolves in an ellipse. Let's practice with one more example. Try to solve this equation on this interval with these initial conditions. The procedure must be familiar by now. T and y equal to ODE 45 at sign f. I specify the interval and initial conditions. Then, as expected, function dy dt equal to f of t comma y. And to define this function f, we only need to find out how to write the output dy dt. I add a plot command to see the results. And that's it. Thank you for watching. In my next tutorial, I'm going to explain advanced features of ODE45 and similar commands to solve differential equations. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. Bye bye.